Bristol Flyers Podcast.
Bonjour! Welcome to this week's episode of the Bristol Flyers Podcast, proudly powered by Web Gains. Joel Osborne, Sam Hardy with you as always. Sam, how are you, sir?
Not doing too badly, Joelie. How are you doing, my man?
Yep, very, very good, because the Flyers just absolutely pumped the Leicester Riders on Sunday.
Absolutely pumped doesn't even quite do it justice, Joelie. That was incredible. I'm sure we'll talk about it later on in the show, but that was just something else.
Yeah, what a way to bounce back from a six-game losing skid. I mean, you couldn't have written the more perfect game for Flyers to bounce back. We've got producer Dan with us as always. Dan, did you watch the Leicester game?
I didn't see it. I was working on other stuff. I couldn't see it. But wow, what a result.
It was the perfect gift for all the Flyers mums out there. So a very happy Mother's Day to all of you, the amazing basketball mums. And yeah, that win was for you. Incredible. Great, great win for the Flyers. We'll talk about the game in more detail later on in the show. But coming up on this week's show, we take the podcast, Sam, on the road to our annual sponsors basketball tournament, which is a very, very fun day for all involved.
It was hectic. I was not expecting there to be that many people. I think there was over 100 people in that, in SGS, wasn't there?
11 teams in total.
Amazing.
12 sponsors, because obviously one of the teams were two sponsors merged together. The most sponsors we've ever had at a Flyers sponsors tournament. We do this every single season with the Bristol Flyers, and I thought it's good for us to maybe highlight it on an episode of the podcast. It's a chance for us to meet our sponsors, learn more about them, and just show, you know, one of the many benefits you get of being a Bristol Flyers partner is you get an invite to this sponsors basketball tournament, and you get to see what it's like on the other side of the court. And there are people of all abilities there. I mean, there was newbies to the game. There were people out there dunking the ball. It was organized chaos at its best.
Do you know what? I've just realized, Joel, I had to leave early for my own basketball game in the evening. I actually don't know who won still.
You'll find out very, very soon, because we'll be heading over there. Also on this week's show, we're talking about the first leg of the ENBL playoff quarterfinal against BC Siauliai, and we'll be looking ahead to Tuesday's second leg out in Lithuania. Plus, we'll be chatting ahead of this week's All-Star game, because of course, Sam, the podcast goes on the road next week to the Copper Box for our All-Star special. But first, before we head over to our sponsors basketball tournament, just a quick reminder, if you are enjoying the podcast, please share it with a friend. If you're listening on the audio feeds, give us a rating and a review on usual podcast provider. Make sure you hit subscribe so that every new episode automatically gets downloaded straight to your podcast feed, so you know as soon as it comes out. Or if you're watching the podcast on YouTube, please like, comment and subscribe. And remember, you can reach out to the show via email now on the electronic mail. Hello at bristolflyers.co.uk, and you can let us know your thoughts in more than 240 characters.
Electronic mail.
Yeah, so there we go.
Do you remember your first email, Joel, you ever got?
No, I had no idea, mate.
In our family, my brother started an email address a while back. He was probably 12, I can't remember, and he had a girlfriend at the time, and she broke up with him, and that was his first ever email he received.
You're dumped by email.
Yeah, literally.
Oh, goodness. Amazing. So if you've got a more funny story than getting dumped via email, let us know your funny Flyers stories. Hello@bristolflyers.co.uk. Right, let's talk Flyers sponsors basketball tournament. And Sam, of course, you work in the commercial team at Bristol Sport. So many great sponsors that sponsor the Bristol Flyers. How great was it for you to see them all getting together? Because it's a great networking opportunity as well, isn't it?
You never know with these things how they're going to go. You never know how sort of competitive they're going to be, how excited people are going to be. And I'm not even joking, Joel. They were taking it very seriously, weren't they?
Yeah, they were. They were. We actually went down there with the mics. We've put together a lovely package for the day. Producer Dan, you love a package, don't you?
Oh, you know me. I love a package.
Well, are you ready for me to get my package out right here on the podcast?
Oh, I think so.
Right. Shall we get to it, Sam?
Let's do it.
Let's head over to the Bristol Flyers Sponsors Basketball Tournament.
This is the Bristol Flyers Podcast.
Hey Flyers fans, this is the part of the show where we give a huge thank you to our podcast sponsor, WebGains. We've got Rob over there in the house, and without their support, this podcast would not be possible.
Now, WebGains is the smart affiliate marketing network who have an unbelievable track record when it comes to empowering advertisers and publishing partners to reach their potential and achieve game-changing results.
They connect businesses with top affiliates who can promote your products and services, reaching a wider audience and driving more revenue.
And here's the best bit, Flyers fans. WebGains provides you with detailed reports and analytics to track the performance of your affiliate marketing campaigns, making it easy to see the results of your hard work and investments.
But don't just take our word for it. Here's Rob from WebGains to tell you more.
Did you know that last year affiliates helped sell 12 billion worth of products for British brands? And every £1 spent on affiliate marketing by advertisers, also known in our channel as retailers, returned an average of £12.40.
That is actually crazy. When you spend £1,
you get £12 back.
£12.40 back. It's so good.
It's amazing.
It's a good deal, isn't it?
And not only are WebGains sponsors of the Bristol Flyers podcast, but their company logo is also once again on the front of our home and away playing shorts, inspiring the team to make smarter connections, just like they do for thousands of brands on their international affiliate network.
So if you're ready to skyrocket your online presence and drive more sales, visit webgains.com and see how they can assist you in the world of affiliate marketing.
That's webgains.com, WebGains.com. Give your business the assist it needs with WebGains Affiliate Network.
This is the Bristol Flyers Podcast.
Right, we are here at the Bristol Flyers Sponsors Basketball Tournament. Sam, are you excited?
I am so excited. It is packed in here. There are more people than we've ever had at a Sponsors Tournament. Is that right, Joel?
Yeah, we've got 11 teams today competing in the Sponsors Tourney. I think last year we had about 6 or 8, right?
Yeah, but and it also feels like every team's brought more people, so it is crazy in here. But very excited. Very keen to see what happens, and I cannot wait to see who the winner is.
So we're going to find out more about the teams. We're going to meet some of the players. Every team is coached by a Bristol Flyers first team or a Bristol Flyers women's player. Super exciting. Let's go find out and see who we can speak to. Right, we found Mike English from the Bristol Sport Foundation.
Hi guys.
Mike, you are running the Sponsors Tournament today. We mentioned a lot more people here than last year, right?
Yeah, I think it's pretty much doubled the amount of teams from last year, so from about 6 to 11, 12 this year. So yeah, a bit of a logistical nightmare in the background, but hopefully lots of opportunities for the sponsors to play some basketball this evening.
And with so many teams in the tournament, what's the format? Is it group stage and knockout, or how's it going to play out today?
So we've got 3 pools on the go, and then from that we will take the top team from each pool. They'll go on to the final, and they'll be accompanied by the best runner-up in each pool.
Now, you've had a little look at them warming up. Have you got your eyes on who you think the winner might be already?
I'm not a betting man, but I would have to say I think the sports clinic, however loyal to the game, do have some athletes there that I think that's probably going to be our final.
I was going to say, for the listener, I'm looking around here and I'm literally seeing people of all abilities. I mean, there's newbies to the game. There are some people that are absolutely massive as well, aren't there, Sam?
Mate, that guy just did a spin move to lay up. Like, that was actually sick. Haboo have got some force to recommend, I'm telling you.
And Mike, obviously today is the Sponsors Tournament, but if you're not a sponsor of Bristol Flyers and you want to get involved in this sort of staff engagement piece through the Bristol Sport Foundation, there's Corporate Basketball Tournament coming up very soon, isn't there?
Yes, there is the Corporate Basketball Tournament coming up in April, and that's a fantastic opportunity for corporates to come down, enjoy a sporting tournament, network with other corporates, but most importantly, have fun and enjoy the evening together, and a little bit of team building as well, which goes a long way.
So if you're not a sponsor of Bristol Flyers and you do want to get involved with this, do check it out right now over the Bristol Sport Foundation website to enter your team. Places are filling up fast, right?
They are, mate. We're looking to, it's going out. It's been out a number of weeks now, actually. I know you guys pushed it on the pod. The Flyers pushed it on social media platforms. And there's been a number of bookings. So, they're filling up pretty rapidly. So, don't miss out, essentially. It's always a great tournament. And we always have a good giggle afterwards as well.
Amazing stuff. Well, Sam, we know the format at a tournament. Should we go and see, should we meet some of the teams and some of the coaches behind these teams?
Let's do it.
Right, we have just finished game number 1 of the Flyers Sponsors Basketball Tournament. I'm with Rob, captain of Team X Ledger. Rob, how'd you get on?
Got the win, on to the next.
Got the win, on to the next. Talk to us about today. It's a great bit of engagement, isn't it? You guys having fun out there?
Yeah, it's tough. Like, everyone's athletes and we're not. But we won, so that matters. Teamwork, I think, is our athleticism.
Have you got many players on your team that have played basketball before?
No.
You're all newbies?
Yeah, I played before as a kid, but I don't really count. I bounced the ball a few times, but yeah, so no, not really.
And also, you're being coached by Roel Graham-Bell. What's he like as a coach?
Tough, but good.
Come on. You know,
there.
Come on, first win.
How's your team getting on so far? You happy? Happy with the team so far?
Easy win, easy win. Got it done, and you know, on to the next one.
Maybe a bit of coaching in your
Like teamwork.
I mean, it was all them. It was all them, though. I'll be honest, I barely did anything. But you know, on to the next one.
Well, Ro, we'll catch up with you guys later on in the tournament. Congratulations on the first win, and good luck for the rest of the way.
Thanks, man.
So I am here with Borough Bristol, the cafe who we had on the podcast not too long ago, Jolie. Now, guys, you had your first game. How did it go?
Not great. Not what we were expecting, but we live and learn, so ready for the next one.
What was the score in the first game?
First game? I think it was like 12-2 or 12-4.
Have you got any messages for all the fans out there to support Borough today?
If you don't make it here, come over, have some coffees.
I've got a message for you. There's going to be some flyers on seats very, very soon for discount code for Borough Bristol. So make sure you look out for that future Bristol Flyers home game.
Guys, it's so good speaking to you. Thank you for being on the podcast. Good luck today and we'll see you soon.
Thank you.
Cheers. All right, we are here now with Team The Sport Clinic. I've got Phil from The Sport Clinic and I've got their coach, Trajan Jacob, sporting a very nice Sport Clinic tee. Talk to us about it.
Well, you know, my guy Phil had to get me right. You know, it's only right. The game plan is simple. Shoot threes, transition, and play a tad bit of defense. Just a little bit. More possessions, more trade balls.
So Trajan Jacob's style of play is just get buckets out there. We've got Phil from the Sport Clinic. You've been treating the players this season. How have you found it this season?
Yeah, it's been great working with the guys. They're all fantastic bunch of athletes. And I enjoyed them coming into clinic and coming to the home games. And it's fantastic to have TJ coaching us today. I thought if we're wearing the same T-shirt, I reckon nobody will notice if I just slide off the court. TJ slides on, gives a tomahawk jam, and you know, gets the points on the board for us to be great.
And you are a regular podcast listener as well, aren't you?
I certainly am. I harass you on a regular basis. And but yeah, no, it's great what you guys do. You're both really good at your job. And it helps build like the Flyers community. So.
Look at him, eh? He loves the podcast.
I'm media trained, all right? Former athlete, you know. The Sport Clinic, powered by Soak and Drip Candy, from everyone knows the famous RGB, and it's keeping us sugared up, possibly crashing about 90 seconds in, missing some layups. But no, we love Soak and Drip Candy at the Sport Clinic. Go and buy yourself a bag.
I'll get me some of this.
Sam's going to have some Soak and Drip Candy on the podcast right now. Phil, before we let you go, talk to us about the shoes. You got some big shoes on, my man.
Lucas, baby. Lucas. All about it. They're comfortable, man. They do the job. I'm a fan.
Have you guys played a game yet so far? How are you getting on in the game so far today?
No. They're obviously leaving the best to last. So we're going to come in, then we've got back-to-backs. But you know, we're pros, but we are all very much amateurs. But we're going to treat it professionally. Let's get in, do the job. As coach said, play some D. I'm not very good at D. Get some threes. I can't really shoot threes very well. And then win the game.
There we go. You've heard it here first. And TJ, we've got to give a nod to this weekend, of course. All-Star weekend, yep. You're in the dunk contest. Yep. What have you got up your sleeve?
I can't give away the goods, but just know I got something in store. I think it'll shock you guys. I haven't pulled it out yet, so hopefully y'all like it and I can at least advance and hopefully win. But we're going to see.
Have you been practicing? Have you been practicing the dunks for that?
Honestly, no. No. We're going off pure vibes, but I got some stuff in the memory bank. I think I get the job done.
Great stuff. Well, thanks for joining us today at the Sponsors Tournament. Thanks for coming on the podcast. Sam, let's see who else we can chat to.
We are here with the wonderful Watchers of Bath. We've got owner James and we've got team coach Pasquale Landolfi. Now, I think Pasquale was chosen as the team coach because he actually made the half-court shot to win a watch at the beginning of the season. James, how are you finding basketball so far?
Knackering. Absolutely knackering. Much more tiring than I thought. Now I realise how unfit I am. And I'm about 3 foot short as well. So we're doing our best shot. Our aim is just to score a point in every game.
You guys are used to being on the, you know, watching the Flyers this season, but yeah, being able to try it, see what it's like, it's a lot harder than it seems, right?
Yeah, and especially that three-point line. When you're watching a game, you're just thinking, just make that shot, make that shot. But when you're by that line, it feels a long way away.
Now, James, obviously Pasquale's your coach. How's he doing so far? Is he doing a good job for you?
I mean, he's trying his best, but he was dealt a pretty rough hand of amateurs. He's been motivational, being tactical, but to be honest, I don't think it makes much difference.
Pasquale, what can you say to the team to get them going right now?
We're improving every game. The first game, we weren't really sure what was going on. The second game, actually getting closer to the basket, trying to make some more scores. So now the third game, we're going to make some buckets. We're going to win some games. And then who knows what happens after that.
Well, we look forward to seeing it. Just finally, James, this is your first year of sponsorship with the Bristol Flyers. Of course, the Sponsors Tournament is a big perk of being a Flyers sponsor. You get to try it out. How have you found sponsoring the team overall this season?
Oh, it's been absolutely great. Really enjoyed it. But best of all, it's coming to actually watch them play. It's coming down here. Last week, we had our kids down. Absolutely loved it. It's great entertainment for them. It's a special night. And it's a great atmosphere. Sold out arena. Oh, it's absolutely rivals Ashton Gate.
And the future of Flyers is so promising. I mean, you talk about Ashton Gate, hopefully one day. How great would it be to see them down there at Ashton Gate, right next door to the stadium?
It's going to be amazing to get all the families out, get the kids out, and also the great American imports that we've got. Such a benefit to the game. I mean, you've got guys like Brad as well, who just role models and shows kids that actually there's a great sport here. It's reaching all different talents, all different skills, and also it's a team game, but also there's so much individual ability in this sport, and one individual performance can make that difference.
Yeah, there is a huge community behind Flyers. Our sponsors are a key part of that Flyers family. James, thank you so much for joining us on the podcast. Yeah, best of luck with the rest of the tournament.
Thank you, mate. Cheers. Appreciate it.
All right, I am now joined by Team Everlast. I've got Reggie here from Everlast, and they are coached by none other than Flyers big man, Brad Green. Reggie, we'll start with you. How's the team getting on so far?
Very good. We've won 2 games now, so very good.
Perfect, 2-0. Yeah, I think I saw in your last game you went up and dunked it as well, is that right?
Yep.
It's supposed to be layups only in this competition, I heard. There's no dunking allowed.
No one ever said that. No one ever said that.
Brad, how have the Team Everlast been so far?
They're all competitors. They're out there, they're hustling, they're really sharing the ball together. And I mean, Reggie's doing an impressive job right now, so hopefully we can keep it going and win this whole thing.
Now, there's a few teams here, Reggie, that are saying they're going to win. Habu for one, a couple of the others. What do you have to say to those guys?
I mean, they can try, but at the end of the day, we're going to win it, so it's all good.
And Reggie, of course, you work down at our partners at Everlast. They're our official gym partner for the Bristol Flyers. Second year of partnership now. You seeing the guys in there regularly visiting the Everlast gym in Filton?
Yeah, I do, because I work from the house, so I also see them coming in and out every day, so it's good to see them coming in and working out, getting better every day, so it's good.
You got Brad Green popping in, getting some reps in. Brad, you often go to Everlast gyms?
Absolutely, they got great facilities over there, and I mean, what more could you ask for from a gym, so I really appreciate them.
Don't lie, Brad, you don't lift.
Brad, before we let you guys go, got to give a nod to All Stars this weekend. You're the starter for Team South. We've got our All Star special next week down at the All Star game. But just a little preview for the fans. What can they expect from Brad Green on the court on Sunday at the All Star game?
I mean, I'm going to try to bring what I bring to every game. I'm going to compete. I'm going to have fun, and hopefully, we'll give the fans a show.
Any threes as well? I see he's 1 3-pointer. I heard.
We'll see if I have that in my pocket during the time.
Watch this space. We'll see a 3-pointer from Brad Green at the All-Star game this Sunday. Guys, thank you so much for joining us. Best of luck with the rest of the tournament.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
I am here with Loyal to the Game. I have Anna and Marley with me. Guys, how is it going so far?
It's going great.
Have you won any games yet?
Yeah, we won both.
Ooh, 2 from her. Have you been out on the court?
I went out on the court, scored a 3. I'm joking. Oh. He scored the 3. Did I didn't really. I'm going to score a 3 next time.
Watch this space. Now, Marley, do you play basketball already? You don't you?
Yeah, I play already.
Do you play for your school?
Yeah, I play for school.
I like that. So they've won 2-0, Joel. Oh, they're doing really well. So if, in case you didn't notice, loyal to the game, Anna Basie provides some unreal clothing for all of our players. They all look really cool. Anna, why did you start loyal to the game?
My kids, all playing sports. I love watching them and the passion that goes behind it. So I thought I'd start a brand. And so everyone can feel that passion.
And it looks great, doesn't it, Joel?
It looks amazing. Now, we want to know, what would it take to get a Joel, Sam and producer Dan branded podcast t-shirt from Loyal to the Game? Can we make it possible? What do you think?
Absolutely.
Let's do it. Oh, my goodness. I wasn't expecting you to say yes.
Yeah, why not?
Do it. I'm thinking of some catchphrases, Sam, that we could do for the...
100%.
Get a t-shirt that says, let's get to the news. Yeah. Well, thank you so much for joining us on the pod. Best of luck with the rest of your games. And hopefully...
I'm going on now, so...
Hopefully, we'll see you in the final.
Okay.
We are here with Habu. We have CJ and Levi. Guys, have you won any games so far?
We've won two games. Lost 0. 2-0, baby. 2-0. About to go 3-0 right now.
Okay, Levi, what do you think? What's going for your team? Why are they so good?
Honestly, we got everything. We got the bigs. We got shooters. We got guys that want to play defense. And we got guys that want to score.
What's CJ bringing to the team, Levi?
Everything from points to rebounding to toughness. We got a real good one right here.
Now, CJ, can you just give us, this is your second year a part of Habu sponsorship. Habu are our front of shirt sponsor, principal partner. Can you tell us a little bit about what Habu done and your enjoyment with the sponsor so far?
So Habu, we're a great company. We work with distribution, we work with Royal Mail, DPD, Every. We get their stock and we get returns and then we all ship it back out. We sort it out in our warehouses and we're a big, huge company that's gonna keep growing.
Now, have you been down to any BBL games? Oh!
Oh! Forfeit in the studio, watch this space!
Have you been to any British Basketball League games this year so far?
Yeah, I've been to quite a lot of them. I mean, I've enjoyed every single one.
We have a rule on the podcast that anytime someone says the B and the L, they have to do a forfeit.
We gotta go.
You guys gotta go.
Oh, yeah.
Enjoy the
dub. Let's do this. Fire!
They've got off to the next game. It's hectic here, Sam. You've got to do a forfeit when we get back to the studio. Are you excited?
I cannot wait, Joe.
Let's go see who else we can find. Okay, we have managed to find Team Subway. We've got Sue and Ryan from Subway. They are coached by Bristol Flyers forward Leslie Smith. How's your team getting on so far today?
I mean, you know, the first two games are a bit rough. We played three games or two?
Three.
Yeah, the first two games are a bit rough, but we got a victory in the last game. We played together, got some key stops. It was a close game. I think we won by two.
And you've been involved with this sponsors tournament now for a number of years with Flyers. It's a really fun event in the calendar, isn't it?
It is. It is a fun event. You know, get to spend some time with the sponsors. See, they have some talent in here, actually. You see a couple people. They know what they're doing a little bit. So it's fun to sit and watch.
Ryan, are you a big basketball player in your spare time at all or no?
Absolutely not. I'm not fit enough either. I think that is definitely apparent that I need to sub off after about 2.5 minutes.
And Sue, of course, you went down to Poland to watch the Flyers out in the ENBL this season. How did you find the trip?
Oh, it was amazing, and the guys won, which was even better. But Subway's been sponsoring or partners with the guys now for probably about nearly 15 years. So, we've watched Andreas kind of develop the teams over the years, and I mean, we just love it. We love the guys, we love like the Bristol Flyers, and we're just great to be a part of it.
And how much have you enjoyed the growth of the club over those last sort of 10, 15 years or so?
Yeah, it's been great. You know, they're more and more professional, and the games are getting quicker, and the guys are getting better and taller. That's great.
Well, we really appreciate your support. Best of luck for the rest of the tournament, and fingers crossed, maybe see you guys in the final.
Yeah.
They'll be there. We'll see them in the final.
We are here with Clifton Coffee. We have Pete the Hooper. Hooper, the only one scored points to you so far, is that right?
Oh, nothing but net. Nothing but net. 3 points all the way from downtown.
Now, how many games have you played so far, Pete?
Two.
Have you won any of them?
No, but it's been fun. And it's all about the experience, right?
So. No, I'm afraid, Pete, it's all about winning. Corey, how are you feeling about your team so far?
Well, you know, we're 0-2 right now, but, you know, the success is brewing at Clifton Coffee, baby. Put that on your t-shirt.
I love it.
Do you know which teams you played so far, then? Which teams you played against so far?
We played the Sports Clinic, the guys over there, and watches a bar. So I think they're two toughest teams, I think.
They do look very big, yeah, don't they? Yeah, I don't know about you, Sam, but I was really, really looking forward to the El Coffee Co between Clifton Coffee and Borough Bristol.
I know we might just have to play a little friendly one of that in a minute, I think, because we were quite keen on that as well. So.
And just a quick final word. I mean, Corey, you've done this a number of years now. The Flyers Sponsors Tournament. You get the partners involved. They get to see what it's like playing on the court. How much do you enjoy coaching teams during the Sponsors Tournament?
It's pretty fun, you know. We just get a little evening just to have some fun. Everyone's got positive attitude, some nice vibes. Some teams take it a bit far, but, you know, we're having fun with it.
Guys, good luck to the rest of the tournament. I hope you get at least one dub in you. And we'll see you very soon. And let's go find other people to chat to. So we are here with Ed from Capio Recruitment. Now, Capio are the back of short sponsor for the women's team, which is amazing to see. Ed, how are you doing today? How's the tournament going for you?
We're out.
What, because you finished all your games or you didn't win any games?
Both. So we kept a clean sheet in the second one, but 0-0 wasn't good enough. And then, yeah, we led twice at the end, and all we had to do was beat a team of PTs, but sadly that was too much for us. So.
Now, Christina, you play for the women's team. Have you enjoyed coaching this team today?
Absolutely. A bit of a conflict of interest today with my fiancé. I might have been a bit harsh on him on the basketball.
I think the coaching was a little bit debatable at times, if I'm honest. But I got benched for the second game.
No domestics on the podcast, please. No domestics here. Now, you obviously have sponsored the women's team this year. Have you been down to any games so far?
Yeah, I've been to five or six, I think, or maybe a few more. Most of the home ones.
Yeah.
It's been a good season, hey?
Yeah, I've really enjoyed it, to be fair. I know a few of the other sort of guys that come along regularly now, so yeah, I'm a regular here as much as I can be.
You're here as much as you're at work these days, right?
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
Christine, have you enjoyed your season so far?
I have, yes. I hope we can finish strong and get a playoff spot, which we're close to at the moment. So yeah, I've enjoyed it definitely, and it's been a pleasure to lead and be a captain for the team this season as well.
But if people want to come down and watch you in action, every game is streamed on YouTube on the Bristol Flyers YouTube channel, and obviously they can come down and watch completely for free as well.
Yes, yeah, definitely. We hope to have more and more fans. I think we had a great season this season, and we gained some new fans. Maybe pinch them from the men's team when they come and watch us as well. But yeah, it's been a great pleasure to play. And I played in 2017, 2018 season or a while back when we won the league. And I can see definitely a difference in the number of fans and the growth definitely for the women's sport as well, which is good.
Yeah, and just a word on that game against Loughborough. I mean, it was a packed house, wasn't it? I mean, that was the first time I think ever we've had a completely packed house for the women's team.
Definitely, yeah, probably a historical moment, definitely. And I think that helps us as well. It definitely gave us a bit more that extra, you know, 6 months on the court, so to speak. So it definitely helps.
Thanks for both joining us on the podcast. Yeah, and I know your tournament's over, but hopefully maybe get involved next year with the Sponsors Tournament.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah, we'll be back. We'll be back. And probably better. Can't
to
be worse.
To redeem themselves.
Yeah. There we go.
Looks like they need to do some Capio recruitment of some more players. Isn't that right, John?
I see what you did there. And that is going to do it. Team Habu are the winners of the Bristol Flyers Sponsors Tournament 2014. An incredible win for Team Habu. They've won it 2-0. A 2-0 win in the final for Levi Bradley and Team Habu. Team ATS Controls and We Do Data, they gave it a valiant effort in the end and they just fell short. Let's go see if we can speak to our runners-up. Okay, I am with our runners-up. It is Team ATS Controls and We Do Data. We've got Jay and Matt. You guys just fell short in that final. So close, it was 2-0.
Second year on the trot to Habu as well. So yeah, it was really close, but next year.
And you guys merged together to form a team today. How have you found it?
Really good, really good fun. Loads of energy from everybody. Really good atmosphere.
Yeah. And these sponsors tournaments, I mean, you guys are partners of the Flyers. It's a great perk that you can get involved with these sponsors tournaments, get coached by a first team player. Yeah. And you've got T. John Lucas as your coach today. How's he been?
Amazing. You'll be gutted with the loss though, so I feel bad. I feel bad for you, but yeah, it's been amazing.
Tijon, talk to us about that final. What happened?
We just couldn't put the ball in the hole at the end of the day, and it'd be like that sometimes. You know, a couple of questionable calls, you know, with our referees, but at the end of the day, I think we played great. You know, we got 3 wins today, and can't be more prouder.
And important to engage with our sponsors as well. They're such a key part of what we do. Without our sponsors, we wouldn't be possible Flyers basketball.
No, yeah, for sure. We had a lot of laughs, talked a great bit, got to know some people, and I think it was overall a great experience and great time with the sponsors today.
And have you found the British Basketball League season so far? Are you enjoying coming down to the Flyers? I know it's been mixed results on the court, but a first venture into Europe as well. Have you found it?
It's been a good vibe. Exciting, family love it. We come every week, pretty much. So yeah, it's been a good season.
And that's the thing with Flyers, isn't it? It's a real community feel around the club. You know, everyone knows everyone. Everyone's such a tight-knit community at Bristol Flyers.
Oh, yeah, the family vibe down here is brilliant. The kids absolutely love it. The kids are down here absolutely every week. The interaction with the players, all of that, yeah, makes for an amazing atmosphere.
If you guys had any words for anyone thinking about sponsoring the Flyers or getting involved with the Flyers, they've got a business of their own, what would you say from first-hand experience?
Do it. Do it. It's great fun. The family can get involved. It's it's good all round fun.
Yeah, exactly the same. To be honest, the returns we've seen on the investment this year have been massive. So I'd really recommend it to anybody that's thinking about doing it. Definitely recommend it.
Amazing. Well, thank you guys for joining us on the podcast. Thank you so much for your support of Bristol Flyers. I know you guys fell short, but I'm sure you'll be back next year to fight to get the title back next year.
We will be.
Well, that is it for our Flyers Sponsors Tournament. Habu are the winners, and I'm joined by Levi Bradley, the coach of Team Habu.
They hate us because they ain't us. It's another thing. I think we're 3-3 back-to-back now. I want to thank everybody from my family, to my friends, my supporters, and these guys over there. They worked so hard to get us there. So shout out to Habu again. And thank you, Joe. Thank you.
How much have you enjoyed sort of, you know, engaging with the sponsors? Because it's a crucial part of Flyers basketball. You know, without the sponsors, it wouldn't be possible Flyers basketball. So being able to sort of give back to them, you know, coach them as well. Yeah. I imagine you must have enjoyed that.
No, I enjoyed it a lot. Great group of people. They were exciting. And honestly, they kept me in it the whole time. Oh, gosh. Here we go.
Tijon Lucas not happy. He said they cheated.
It's all right. But yeah, no, like I said, that was a great group. Now, I honestly can't wait till we win another championship.
There we go. You've heard it here first. Levi Bradley, the coach of Team Habu, who are the winners of the 2024 Bristol Flyers Sponsors Tournament. That's going to do it for our coverage from the Wise Campus. I'll throw it back to Joel and Sam in the studio.
This is the Bristol Flyers podcast.
So congratulations to Team Habu. They've won it once again. They are once again the Sponsors Basketball Tournament champions.
Now, Habu have so many members of staff. I'm not surprised, Joel. They can go around and they didn't have ringers. I know they all work there, but they could literally go to their 800 or so employees and be like, who plays basketball? Come in. And they were dunking it, weren't they? Was that from Habu?
Yeah, they were. I think it was only right that our principal partner won the tournament in the end, right? They won it once again. I think they won it again. I think they won it last year as well. So I think they're the back-to-back, maybe 3 times, maybe 2 times. But they're back-to-back sponsors of basketball tournament champions.
How can any of us be surprised? Habu always deliver.
Hey, there we go.
There you go, lads. I'll have my fiver in the morning. Thank you.
Fiver.
Sam, we need to have a word with Rob from Web Games because I didn't notice the team from our podcast sponsors down there.
I know. What's that all about?
Well, Rob, if you're listening to the podcast, get a team in next season. Where is it? Sam and I play for you. We're part of the Web Games team these days.
Yeah, that's a good point, actually, Joel.
Yeah.
A little Joely baseline. We were having a little bit of a shootout before the weren't we?
We were getting some shots up, making some free throws. Good to see I've still got my free throw technique.
Joel hit 8 from 10 from the free throw line.
Yep, my 3-point technique, not so much.
How many did you get?
I think 4.
Oh, nice. Like that.
But Sam, we also have to talk about this because we spoke with Anna Jagger from our partners at Loyal to the Game, and she promised us she'd get us some Bristol Flyers podcast merch.
Yeah, she did. You've heard it here first. She actually said it live on air, Joel, so we have to get it now.
Producer Dan, would you like a piece of Bristol Flyers podcast merch?
Oh, you know I would.
What would you get on the t-shirt? Because we were talking about this, and I was thinking like maybe a series of slogans from the podcast.
Nice.
So like a t-shirt which says like, let's get to the news.
cheers.
Yeah. Nice.
Or fresh water.
Yeah, fresh waters. Yeah, like a picture of me and Sam holding some fresh waters with the Bristol Flyers podcast logo.
Oh, yes. I mean, both of your faces
Well.
Well, we wouldn't have producer Dan's face. No one knows what he looks like.
Mine would be on the back.
That would be so good.
That would be amazing. So, Anna, let's have these conversations off air and let's discuss some Bristol Flyers podcast merch, please. And you never know, on a future episode, we may be sitting here instead of our Flyers polos. We may be wearing some Loyal to the Game Bristol Flyers podcast merch. So yeah, have a little think. If you've got some ideas of what you want on a Bristol Flyers piece of podcast merch, let us know. Hello at bristolflyers.co.uk or tweet us at Bristol Flyers or any social media platforms. Also, Sam, we've got to say something here because anyone that listened to the VT would have noticed you said a certain three letters.
I literally halfway through, I said it, Joel, didn't I?
I'm going to push the sound. Play a sound. Well, during that little interval there, I managed to go grab my British Basketball League buckets. It's been a long time since I've seen this bucket, isn't it, Sam?
Well, what was the last one? It was you last time, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was, yeah. But the I have to say, there's only one forfeit left in the buckets here. So the forfeit's all yours. And we're going to have to fill up some more forfeits further down the line. We're going to need to put some more in because we've... go on, what does it say, Sam?
I don't even know how we do this. You must be tied to your chair for the remainder of the show.
Oh, okay, I know. How we're gonna do this.
Tape.
It just so happens, Sam, I've got some tape under the desk.
Am I allowed to use my arms or not?
No, you gotta be tied to the chair.
How am I gonna read my notes?
Well, you can like do this like a little T-Rex.
There you go. There we go. Oh yes, here we go. Keep going. Amazing. Oh, beautiful. Oh, amazing. And perfect.
For audio listeners to this pod, hearing those noises from Joel and the tape there was probably quite disturbing. We can only apologise.
Sorry about your ears.
I can't reach my headphones.
You sit there like that. Lovely.
Yeah.
Oh, if anyone watching this on YouTube is amazing. Sam has been tied to his chair with parcel tape, and we are ready to continue.
Can I ask a serious question, Joel?
Yep.
Have you done a risk assessment for this?
What, being tied up?
Well, what if there's a fire alarm? How am I getting out?
Oh, I will cut you free.
Oh, thank you.
You're
mate.
On wheels, aren't you? We'll just wheel you out.
Yeah, we'll just push you out, Sam. So there we go. Let's crack on with the rest of the podcast. Right. So, yes, an amazing sponsors tournament, as always. Congratulations to our sponsors for all their support this season. Hope you enjoyed your time down at the sponsors basketball tournament. And if you are a business that wants to maybe sponsor the Flyers next season, do get in touch. You can reach out to us and we'll put you in touch with our commercial manager, Steve Devereaux. Great guy is Steve Devereaux, isn't he, Sam?
I don't have a lot of comments right now, Joel, because it's pulling the hair out of my arms as I move.
Oh, dear. This looks amazing.
But Steve is a good guy. Yeah, he is.
So reach out if you want to get involved with the sponsor for next season and you want to get invited to the sponsors tournament, do so. We've got some great opportunities available. And yeah, hopefully we'll have your support for the future seasons. And if you want to get involved with events like the Sponsors Basketball Tournament, we spoke to Mike English there on the VT from the Bristol Sport Foundation. The Bristol Sport Foundation is running a corporate basketball tournament in April. I can just hear the sound of your tape in the background there, Sam, as he's just moving around. Corporate basketball, it takes place at the SGS College Arena Tuesday, April 16th. If you're not a sponsor of the Flyers and you want to get involved in a basketball tournament like this, reach out to the Bristol Sport Foundation, all the details on the website, Tuesday, April 16th. Great team building exercises, £700 per team, maximum of 10 players. All abilities are welcome. Every team coached by a Flyers first team player, just like the sponsors basketball tournament. All funds raised from the tournament will go to the Flyers community program to support more children from low income families access basketball in their community through Project Takeoff.
Now, Joel, Bristol Sport have put in a team. Are you willing to get them boots on and play for the Bristol Sport team or not?
Potentially. Well, are you thinking about it? You want to do it?
I'm thinking about it. I have had one of the sponsors who is going to do it, who we already know, I won't say who, invite me into their team as well already.
Oh, okay. So you've got some split loyalties.
Split loyalty, but I'll be there, whatever.
What's it going to take for you to join Bristol Sport Team then? If I join, will you join?
If you join, I want to be on the other team so I can beat you.
Brilliant. Okay, well, maybe I will join. We'll see. Just, Dan, what do you reckon about getting a Brandvox team in? Team behind the scenes at the podcast?
I mean, we can give it a go. I think Freddie will be pretty good playing.
Producer Fred.
Yeah, Producer Fred would be quite handy. But the rest of us don't hold much hopes.
Bully's pretty tall.
Bully is pretty tall. Yep. He's also 65 this year, I think. So,
what are you trying to say, Dan?
No, nothing. Nothing. I'm just pointing that
out. It's an inclusive tournament,
yes,
okay?
It is.
For the podcast listener, Jeremy Ball, aka Bully, at our team behind the team at Brandvox, who produced the podcast along with our Flyers TV games. He is the mastermind of all things technical, isn't he, Dan?
He sure is, yeah.
He knows all the cables. Any problem that comes with any issues, he knows at the back of his hand, and he solves every single problem that is thrown at him.
He pretty much built this studio you're sat in.
He did build the studio with.
Thank you, Jeremy.
But he probably can't play in the Thompson Basketball Tournament, like you say. But maybe he could. I mean, all abilities are welcome. So maybe see if he wants to sign up for it.
What, yeah, I'll let him know.
Yeah, let him know. Sam, great chat from the sponsors Basketball Tournament, but it's time for us to get to the news.
You're listening to the Bristol Flyers podcast.
Right.
What a catchphrase you've got there, Joel. It's like, whammy.
Whammy. Let's get to the news. Right, well, let's take a look at what's been happening in the British Basketball League and beyond over the last 7 days. And let's start by talking about what happened first, because we've got lots to catch up on here. But first of all, the Flyers were in ENBL action last week. And we didn't talk about it on last week's show because we actually recorded the podcast before the first leg took place.
Yep.
So we can talk about it now.
I mean, it was a good game, actually. Really good game of basketball. It's such a shame. Basketball is a game of margins. Levi just standing out of bounds on the final play of the game. We were down by 6. As he passed it over to Tevo, he hit a 3, which was chalked off because he just stepped out of bounds. If that hadn't have happened, we might have been going into the second leg not 8 points. Was it 8 points?
It was 8 points,
points down. Maybe just 3 points down, Joel.
Yeah. It's the finest margins. It's the difference maker between, you know, it's crazy how much one play can swing a tide of a game so much. So just to run it through for you, Flyers, they went head-to-head with the Lithuanian side, BC Siauliai, in the first leg of the ENBL playoffs and have an 8-point deficit to make up on Tuesday's game out in Lithuania. First thing I noticed, Sam, from this game, I don't know about you, was the absolute size advantage of every player on the Lithuanian roster over the Bristol Flyers. I think every player had like 2 or 3 inches on the Flyers, right?
Who was his name? Pavelka, was that his name?
Thomas Pavelka.
He was seven foot two. You should have seen him in the warm-ups. He was almost having to duck when he went through the hoop, mate.
Yeah, he was big. But Brad Green did a really good job on him. Like the first play of the game, they win the tip-off, they get it into Pavelka, and Brad Green just swats it off the backboard, sort of letting him know his presence early on. It was amazing, wasn't it?
Well, Brad is not quite as tall as him, but he is definitely stronger than him, isn't he, John?
Oh, 100%. Brad won that battle, like, hands down there. Siauliai scored the first 5 points of the game. They built a double-digit lead off the back of a Leonard Thorpe 3, who I thought was incredible. I don't know about you. He finished with a near triple-double in that game.
He was good. I didn't like his attitude always, though, Joel.
He was... He's let us knew about it, but lots of players do that. It's part of the game, isn't it, trash talk?
There was someone on the baseline or the sideline, I can't remember who it was, talking to me afterwards, and they were saying how he was doing the last play of the game. He was putting it in, and he was talking to TJ, I think, and he was going, just to let you know, it's a, you know, aggregate score, so we aren't just going to dribble it out. We are going to try and score it. We're going to, like, just so you know, just so you're aware. And the guy on the side was like, oh, that was quite nice of it.
Thanks for letting us know, mate. Appreciate it. While he drains 3 threes in the fourth. Siauliai led by as many as 17 in the second. Flyers came soaring back to make it a 2-point lead off a Levi Bradley made 3. And I don't know about you, but the Wise Arena, the roof, just came off on that Levi Bradley triple.
Yeah, we're going to have to work out ways that we stop rain getting in now the roof's been blown off so much.
I know, it was incredible. The fans were raucous at the SGS Wise campus and they came back from 17 down. So that was a huge confidence boost going into the second leg, knowing that they can already come back from a 17-point deficit against this team. Flyers, they did lead by 2 heading into the final quarter. And then, of course, spoke about Thorpe. He took over in the fourth. He knocked down 3 threes in the fourth quarter. quarter, three straight threes. Every time Siauliai sort of threatened to run away with it, Flyers had a response. And I think we were, as you say, we spoke about the deficit there. I think we were very unlucky not to have this as one possession game going into the second leg.
Yeah, it was annoying. Like, we obviously had that out of bounds, and then there was a mix-up on D, and they had basically an open backdoor layup, didn't they? So
yeah, it was. Before that, Bennett van der Plas with an outrageous lob, alley-oop finish. One of the biggest alley-oops I think I've seen at SGS this season.
Yeah, I didn't want to mention that, Joe. It was unbelievable, wasn't it?
Yeah. As you say, Levi Bradley then stepped out of bounds on the following play. Siauliai advanced the ball out of timeout with about five or six seconds to go.
Yeah.
And then they stretched the lead out with that Polis Danisavage's dunk. Two-handed dunk on the buzzer, which saw them push it out to 8 on the night, which does mean that Flyers need to win by 9 points or more on Tuesday night's game against, or I should say Tuesday night, Tuesday afternoon's game, in fact,
yeah,
in the UK, against the BC Siauliai. Remember, it's only half time in this series, and we've got to look at it as Flyers, they're down by 8 at half time. And how many games this season have we been in Bristol Flyers where we trail by more than 8 at half time and come back and sort of pushed it late in the game or won it, in fact?
I think plenty of times, Joel. I've got a big question for you, though. How's your multiple of 8 addition and subtraction?
I think the way we play it on commentary is we just focus on winning the game, and then when it gets to the fourth quarter, then we talk about aggregate. So I think that's the way Coach K will look at it. Win the game, and then we'd be like, okay, we need to push out to 3 more points or 4 more points to take the game.
Okay, I got you.
So that, I think we're going to look at it that way. As you say, all to play for going into the second leg. Brad Green, 20 points, 10 rebounds in the first leg. Keely Johnson, 16 points. Levi Bradley with 15 points. Good all-round effort from the Flyers on the offensive end. But Flyers just 61% from the free throw line in that game. So left a few points at the line. And as you say, even if with all those mistakes that happened on the court, if we knocked down our free throws, this again would have been a tie game or a very close game going into the second leg. So it just shows again how important those free throws really are. Also, now we know, Sam, the winner of this series, because Newcastle played against Bakken last night in their second leg. We know the winner of this series will take on Bakken in the final four. Did you watch the game last night, the second leg, Newcastle versus Bakken?
So we've got a group for this podcast, and I wasn't watching it. I forgot it was even on, to be honest with you. And then Joel started messaging in like, guys, Shane, what's going on? And I was like, all right. So I turned it on, and I only got to see overtime, and it was amazing.
Yeah, I mean, Newcastle trailed by 5 points after the first leg at the Virtue Motors Arena. Bakken actually stretched their lead out to double figures on aggregate in the first half, and then an incredible third quarter comeback from Newcastle. They outscored Bakken 32-12.
Oh my goodness me.
To retake the lead on aggregate as well. Taj Green was incredible in that third quarter.
What was he doing? Hitting threes?
He hit threes. He was driving inside. He's showing the full arsenal in this game. Producer Dan, I know you watched this game as well, right?
Yeah, I mean, Taj, I think there was about 3 dunks that he'd like absolutely smashed in. It was unbelievable. He was brilliant.
Yeah.
Taj Green can do that. I remember last year we were playing against Manchester, who we played for last year, and he turned it on. We lost 108 to 101 because he hit something like, I think it was 8 from 9 threes against us. He just can do it, can't he?
Yeah, he's got that ability to really like switch a game on its head.
And he was enjoying himself as well. He was like hanging off the basket a few times too. He was enjoying himself.
Technical foul.
So so they were out in Bakken at Aarhus, and they actually, just to sort of run it through towards the end, they had to win by 5. They ended up winning the game by 5. They actually took the lead in overtime. And then 5 minutes of overtime, there's like 3 minutes left. They had the lead on aggregate, and then Bakken just rallied back and retook the lead.
They were like 4 points clear at one point, like with aggregate, I mean.
Yeah, but
they?
For Newcastle to even force overtime, they had to they played the late game situation. They only let you foul, and then Bakken, I felt, almost threw this game away. They missed free throws down the stretch. They allowed easy transition buckets, and Newcastle took full advantage. And we were all thinking the game was done. And then all of a sudden, they have that 5-point advantage. It goes to overtime, they take the lead in overtime, and then Bakken just came back in the end. It was crazy. Skylar Bolin is just incredible, and also the young guy as well. I can't remember what his name is. The young blonde guy. Knudsen.
To be fair, they hit some shots which like
easily could have bobbled out as well. Dan was telling me, though, that Clutch Johnson got fouled behind the three-point line and had to hit all three free throws to take them to overtime.
He did. And he hit all three, and it forced OT. It was incredible.
Was that on the buzzer?
It was like the last possession or so. Okay, yeah, so
1.6 on the clock, I think.
Unbelievable.
Yeah. So, it was a landing, one of the landing space fouls as well. So they're missing free throws, and then they're fouling three-point shooters at the end, and everyone's thinking, oh, could there be a chance here? And then... Yeah, it's a shame because I would have loved to see Newcastle advance because the winner of that series would have faced the winner of our series. Like, could you imagine if there was an all-British matchup in the Final Four, the ENBL? I would have loved to see that. So I was really rooting for Newcastle to win that game.
I think, how close was Johnson's three to go in?
It bubbled out, yeah.
Imagine if he'd made that and then had a four-point play to win it. That'd have been insane.
That would have been incredible. Newcastle out, back and in to the next round of the Final Four of the ENBL playoffs. And the winner will face either Flyers or Siauliai. We have to win by 9 points or more in the second leg. And don't forget, you can watch the second leg right here on Flyers TV. I'm going to be here in studio with Gareth Till, as always. And don't forget, it is an early tip-off because we are 2 hours behind Lithuania. So our coverage on Flyers TV starts at 3:30 p.m. on Tuesday, this coming Tuesday, ahead of the 4 p.m. tip-off. It's a 6 p.m. tip-off local in Lithuania. So come join us. Put it on while you're finishing up work. And let's see if we can write another chapter of Bristol Flyers history.
After school hoops club.
Yeah, if you've got an after school club and you want to pop it on.
Yeah,
pop it on and watch that instead of training, because it's going to be a big, big moment for everyone involved at the club.
We'll have to get on in the office, Joel.
Oh, yeah, you've got to get it on in the office, 100%. I wish I could watch it in the office, but I'm going to be watching it here. Dan, how's your Siauliai package coming along?
Well, it's getting there. Siauliai is quite difficult to sort of find interesting things to talk about, I'll be honest. But what I can tell you is that there is a meeting place in Siauliai called the Siauliai Cockerel Love Clock.
Oh, my goodness.
And it's a really difficult one to say. I've had to practice that a couple of times. But, yeah, some interesting little bits about that.
No slip of the tongue here on the podcast.
No.
So, yeah, we'll watch out for Dan's package as well, coming on the Siauliai game on Tuesday, because Dan loves getting his package out. Just like I got my package out today for the sponsors tournament. Yeah.
I can't wait for this to be one of the lower to the game phrases we've got.
Let's see your package.
Yeah.
Get your package out. Yeah.
Let's not have that, the one with my face on the t-shirt.
Anna, if you're listening, make some notes, please. but that wasn't the only game that took place this past week, Sam, because there was another one on Mother's Day. And we spoke about it at the top of the show very, very briefly. But an emphatic 37-point win over the Leicester Riders on Mother's Day.
I don't know what to say about this, Joe. I have watched the highlights of this back three times because I was loving every second of it.
Yeah.
It was one of the best games of basketball I've ever seen live. And what was even better is the sadness on... No, this sounds bad, but you should have seen everyone from the Leicester fans to the Leicester, you know, the guys on the bench to the coaching staff. They just didn't know what to do, did they, Joel?
No, they didn't have a Scooby-Doo. I mean, it's just one of those ones where it's like, how do you beat them? Like, it's just one of those ones, I think you just chalk it up as a defeat because everything was going in for us. We're playing incredible. I don't really know where to start on this one. The first quarter, it started very neck and neck. There wasn't actually too much separating the teams early on. I mean, Flyers led by four going into the first media timeout, about four or five minutes into the first quarter. And then coming back onto the court, the Flyers just flipped a switch. They stretched it out to a 12-point lead at the end of the first, 32-20. Levi and Tevin extended the lead to 15 early in the second. Tevin had 25 points of his 31 in the first half alone.
Isn't that... Didn't he do something similar against London?
His last game before that. He had 25 first... I think it's back-to-back games now. He's had 25-point first half.
And then 31 points total.
Yeah. He finished a 31 in that one again. So, incredible.
It was this is not disrespectful in any way, but I think it was quite a quiet 31 points. I got to the end, I was like, Tevo had 31.
Yeah. He does that, I think. You just you look at the stat sheet and you look down and you think, oh, wait a minute, he's got 31 points. But yeah, it's great.
Sneaky little step back threes. Oh, like he finished some unreal ones. I love his little... He does a Euro step like no one I've ever seen, where he literally like splits like the defense so well in like the paint and then pops it up on in, and it's just beautiful.
And it was an efficient 31 points as well. Amazing. Three shots from the line saw Flyers end the half with the biggest ever scoring half. So it was the highest ever scoring half at home
And what was it?
61 points.
Wow. Oh, my. Did we? I think. Doesn't that match our highest ever half when we played against Manchester in the cup?
No, we had more. We only had 66, I think it was. Okay. 65, something like that in the trophy. So it's our highest ever scoring half at home at SGS since joining the British Basketball League. Amazing, isn't it?
And what were they on? They were on
36. So the score was 61-36 at the half. We pushed it out to a 30-point lead in the third. Brad Green scoring 12 third quarter points. We're up in the 90s by the end of the third quarter. We don't often score up in the 90s in a game. There's still 10 minutes to go.
I like playing a game when we're winning by that much, where we were 61 and they won 36 at the half.
Yeah.
Yeah, that where I'm like, right, where in the game will the other team reach 61 points?
Yeah. Yeah.
Do you ever do that?
Yeah, I like that. Yeah, I like that.
So I was like, I reckon by 3 minutes to go in the third quarter, they'll be where we were at halftime. And yeah. I just like it for some reason.
Yeah. So we pushed out to 30 in the third, as you said. The lead stretched to 40 in the fourth. It's like watching the Celtics versus the Warriors, isn't it, in the NBA? And then we saw the bench get emptied in the fourth. Saw first appearance from Max Cooper.
Yes.
Which is great to see.
What guy he is as well, Joel.
Yeah, he's worked hard, he's got his opportunity, and he took it with both hands. He got a few minutes out there at the end. Obviously, Pasquale on the court, so you know, Coach K going deep into the rotation at the end. And Bristol ultimately cruised to the win, 108-71.
Speaking of Max Cooper,
yep.
I managed to get out on the golf course with him, Joel.
Did you actually?
Yeah.
When did you go?
We went on Monday.
Oh, cheers for the invite.
Oh, I didn't want you there.
Ah, brilliant.
we want a good golfers only, Joel.
Oh, brilliant. There we go.
You can ask him who won next time you see him.
Who did win?
You can ask him.
You, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was me, yeah.
All five starters in double figures in this Leicester game. Tevin Ollison earned himself a spot in the British Basketball League Team of the Week. 31 points on 10 for 14 shooting, Sam.
That is unreal.
8 rebounds, 5 assists. Incredible. But the stats don't stop there because Keely Johnson had 23 points on 9 for 12 shooting. Also had 5 steals.
Some great steals, by the way.
Yeah, so there was one steal where he's like, I can't remember who it was.
I know the one you
did. I guess Kimball was dribbling and he just like literally timed it to perfection and got the perfect steal. You know, like on NBA 2K when you got your steal rating ranked up to the top and you press like the X button to get the steal. And all of a sudden, he just rips it away at a bang on the post. It was exactly as he dribbled,
wasn't it?
Yeah, it was like a video game steal.
Yeah,
it was amazing. Like, cause normally, a steal is like you tap the passing lane and you sort of fumble around and you get it in the end. This one was like a perfect yoink. See you later. Go off coast to coast. So Keedy had a great game. Brad Green.
Let me guess.
Double double. 20 points, 15 rebounds. The man continues to get double doubles for fun.
We were joking. I was actually joking with you or Jack. I can't remember. Where it was like I think he got his double double in the third quarter.
Yeah.
And I was just like, oh, bit slow for Brad this week.
Yeah, it was a bit. Yeah. But about time, Brad. Got another quarter to go. You've only just got your double-double. Levi Bradley, 15 points, and Tijon Lucas with 10. And then just a couple of key stats here. Flyers won the rebound battle, 52-39. They won the battle of the paint, 50-34. They only had 9 turnovers, the Flyers.
No way.
They had 19 points off of their turnovers. 20 fast break points. It really was Flyers basketball at its best.
We literally could have beaten any team on that day. Any team in the league.
Yeah, I agree. The performance, the way we were playing, incredible. And what a way to break a 6-game losing skid. And here's something we often get asked about, Sam. And that is, with so many players having a great game on Mother's Day in the win over Leicester Riders, how do we calculate our player of the game that fans often see put out on social media? Now, you'll often see we put another graphic on socials, which is our ATS Controls Efficiency Spotlight. So, sometimes we have got player of the game performance and we want to highlight other players that have also played well. You know, we put up a graphic and a lot of the time, you will see a line on there on that graphic which is called the performance index. Now the index is a number on live stats that we use to calculate a player of the game. It's a formula. It adds up everyone's each player's good things, it takes away their bad things, and it gives you a number, and basically whoever has the higher number is pretty much our player of the game from that game. So, if you click on the live stats link of any game, put it out on social media pre-game, you go to the far right at the very end, you'll see the index. There's two efficiency numbers. One is index and one is plus minus. So we'll talk about index first. The index is a formula takes, as you say, takes all your positives from a game, subtracts all the negatives from the performance to come up with a number. The stats formula is, here we go, this is how you calculate index. It's points scored plus rebounds plus assists plus steals plus blocks plus fouls drawn minus your missed field goals, your missed free throws, your turnovers, your shots rejected, and your fouls committed. When you've got all those numbers, thrown it into the lovely stats calculator, it gives you the index. Now, usually a good number for this, you know, for a standard sort of player and of a game performance, anywhere between 20 and 30, right? So it takes all your good things, takes away all your bad things. If it's above 30, you've had a great game, right? Go what on. Was Tevin Ollison's index on Sunday?
I know you're going to tell me, but...
It was 40!
Are you joking?
Tevin had an index of 40 because, this calculates it all. It takes into account shooting efficiency. So obviously because Tevin has such a great field goal percentage, that's why his number was a lot higher as well.
Because I suppose if you make a three,
yep,
that gives you plus three.
Yep.
If you miss the three, that's just minus one.
Yeah.
So actually it's more beneficial to obviously, I know this can sound weird, but like making a shot is better for your index than missing a shot is bad for your index.
Most of the time the index number is positive.
Okay.
If you're on the court, it finishes positive.
What's our highest ever index as a Bristol, someone in the Bristol Flyers?
Don't throw me under that bus. Don't throw me under that bus. But I think it's above 40.
40's got to be up there, though.
40 is an exceptional performance. Like, you'll see that very rarely. I think there was another, actually saying that, Quade Green of Caledonia got a 40 index as well at the weekend. So that's index. So hopefully you understand what index means. That's how we calculate our player of the game. There's also another stat you'll notice right next to the index, Sam, which is called the plus minus.
I love the plus minus.
So this is another stat that can determine an individual's player's efficiency out there on his impact on the game. And essentially, this is the points differential of the team over the minutes that you were on the court. So here's an example. If I entered a game for the first time when the score is tied at 11 points apiece, yeah?
Yep.
And I play like 3 or 4 minutes, and then I leave the game when get subbed out of the game when we're up by 5, at that point in the game is a plus 5.
So you don't even have to make any of those points yourself.
It's basically the points differential that whilst you were on the court. So it's not as like it's not as in detail as the index number, but it's another way of calculating your efficiency, your impact on a game.
I suppose you could use this number if you were trying to work out what 5 works really well together.
Yeah.
You could look across their stats and go, okay, that 5 was a plus whatever across a game. And,
yeah,
you know, I'm sure there are so many factors which mean that you can't calculate this properly, like in terms of... like be exact, that's the best 5 we should have on together, but I'm sure it does a pretty good job of that, right?
Yeah. So let's say I come out, I've got a plus minus of 5 right now. Let's say I come back into the game, and when I come back into the game, when I've got currently on a plus 5, our opponents outscore us by 2 during that spell. I then get subbed out.
Yeah.
My plus minus is now a plus 3.
Yeah.
You see what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's your individual impact on a game. How many points more or how many points less your team scored whilst you were on the court in your minutes.
So what's weird is you could come out in a quarter, score 30 points,
yep,
be really efficient in your scoring,
yep,
but the other team score 50. This is crazy. I don't know why they were, but the other team scores 50 points.
Yep.
Your plus minus is minus 20.
So that's why it's not always the most accurate way of an individual's performance. It's more of a team. It's your impact on the team.
Yeah, nice.
Whereas the index is your individual impact because it's all your individual stats calculated together to form a number. So there's two ways of measuring a player's efficiency. Keep an eye out on our efficiency numbers for future updates, ATS Controls Efficiency Spotlight, and hopefully now you understand what both the index and the plus minus means. Amazing.
I love this. On the notes, it's not your fault, it's autocorrect, but it's changed Tevin to Kevin.
Yeah.
So Kevin's plus minus on Sunday was also a plus 40.
It was. Tevin, actually, yeah. So not only did Tevin have an index of 40, he also had a plus minus of 40. He also did play 36 minutes, bear in mind.
Who's Kevin?
Kevin Ollison. Shout out Kevin Ollison. But if you look at like the stats from the Leicester game, look at the other team, for example. Jaron Holmes had an index of 20, but a plus minus of minus 25. So it doesn't always calculate your individual performance. It's basically your team's, that the plus minus takes into more consideration the rest of the team's performance around you, whereas the index is purely a individual number. So that's how we use the index always to calculate who is the player of the game.
Great.
So there you go. Hopefully you've learned something there on the Bristol Flyers podcast. We want to sort of, you know, keep educating our fans. If you've got any questions about index or any other questions you want to ask us, do so. Hello at bristolflyers.co.uk.
Or if you want to break up with Joel, email him there as well.
Brilliant. Right, other news to get to, Sam. All-Star Game is this weekend. And yesterday, I actually went up to London with Trajan Jacob and Brad Green for the British Basketball League All-Star Media Day.
Amazing.
Up at the British Basketball League studios.
I saw some of the stories come out. It looked really cool up there.
It was great. We had a whole bunch of things going on. We did video stations, photo stations. There was, you know, standard photos in the kit that, you know, the traditional ones they need. There was a bunch of mini games they filmed, actually.
Was there?
Yeah, there was. Yeah, it was like, you know, the one where you have like the coat hanger, you got to throw.
Oh, I saw that. Yeah, yeah.
There was one with like beer pong cups. You got to throw ping pong balls into cups.
Fresh water cups.
Yeah, there was like a memory game they were doing as well. And also there was a green screen station where they wanted to get some content for the broadcasts. They also got some content for the upcoming playoffs as well. So there was some great stuff in there we did throughout the day. A long day it was, but everyone got everything they needed, which is great. So, yeah, we are ramping up excitement for the British Basketball League All-Star Game, which is on Sunday. Also, don't forget, the Bristol Flyers podcast will be heading to the All-Star Game this Sunday to record next week's episode. Sam and I will be there to report on everything that's going on. So if you're a Bristol Flyers fan and you listen to the podcast and you're going to the All-Star Game, if you've got tickets to the All-Star Game, do get in touch because we want you to feature on next week's show. You can email us, hello@bristolflyers.co.uk. And I believe, Dan, we have actually had an email come through from a supporter who is going to be attending the All-Star Game next week. Is
we
that right?
We sure have, yes. Hello, Joe Webster, who's written an email. He says, "Hi, Joel and Sam. Me, Tara and the boys, Nathaniel and Theo, hello, boys, will be at the British Basketball League's All-Star Game next Sunday. We're there with one of Tara's cousins, too, who used to play a bit of basketball himself down in Worthing. We're really looking forward to the atmosphere at the Copper Box and to see Tevin, Brad and Trajan in action in the All-Star Game and Dunk Contest. Hopefully, we can chat to you during the day. Our seats are redacted. We should be quite close to the front behind the Team North bench, but clearly cheering on Team South."
Nice.
Thanks, Joe Webster.
Amazing. Shout out, Joe Webster. We will come find you. We've got your seat numbers now, so we will come find you on Sunday and we will definitely have a chat with you and your crew. Get your predictions, get your thoughts about All-Stars, let us know what you think of the dunk contest. We'll come find you at some point in the day. And if you want to also feature on the episode, do reach out to the Bristol Flyers podcast. hello@bristolflyers.co.uk. Also, Sam, we've got a bit of an announcement to make about All-Star Game, haven't we?
I'm very excited about this, Joel.
I'm very excited about this as well, because not only will we both be recording the podcast at the All-Star Game next week, but we have been invited to go live on the British Basketball League Twitch account to do an alternative commentary of the All-Star Dunk Contest.
I like the word alternative. I know it means literally just someone else, not the main people doing it, but I'm thinking we should do it a bit alternative, Joel.
Well, I actually spoke to Jose yesterday up at the British Basketball League studios, and he's all for this being a completely relaxed thing.
Like, okay, cool.
So think podcast, and this is what we're doing for the... So basically, you can go on Twitch. If you don't want to watch the Sky Sports commentary of the Dunk Contest, and you're a Bristol Flyers podcast fan, Bristol Flyers podcast listener, you can mute the TV, you can load up Twitch on your phone, and you'll see Sam and I live on the Twitch channel talking about the dunks, reacting to every single dunk as it happens. They said we can take segments of the Twitch broadcast and use them on the podcast as well.
Yes.
And we're going to be live alongside Derek Eze from the British Basketball League. We did a live with him the other week when he came to Bristol. I think it was a Newcastle game, I think it was. Great guy. His reactions to dunks have obviously gone viral on D's Reels. And we're going to be alongside him. I've also been told, Sam, we're going to get given our own scorers judges cards,
yes,
so we can make our own judges on some of the dunks.
Seven! Come on!
So, yeah, watch this space. If you want to watch us or listen to our commentary on Twitch, at British Basketball is the Twitch account. So go subscribe there right now. And also, some of the best bits, if you can't actually listen to the broadcast, or you're going to be there yourself, some of the best bits from that Twitch broadcast will be going into our podcast next week as well. So watch this space. Shout out to the British Basketball League for inviting us to join them on Twitch. And there we go. You're excited to get twitchy, Sam.
I'm a bit twitchy. Ready for it, Jolie.
I'm twitching with excitement right now. I can tell you that for fun. So that's going to be great. And I think, Sam, that is it for this week's news.
You're listening to the Bristol Flyers podcast.
Right, that's going to do it for this week's episode of the Bristol Flyers podcast. Great episode, Sam. Really fun to chat to our sponsors at the Sponsors Basketball Tournament. The Sponsors Basketball Tournament is probably one of the most fun events of the year, isn't it?
Yeah, become a sponsor. Get involved next year. You'll absolutely love it. Just speak to Steve or email us at hello and we can sort you out.
Yeah, congrats to Habu on being crowned winners. Don't forget, join us on next week's show for our All-Star special. We're about to go and take this podcast on the road on Sunday. I don't know what day it's going to come out yet next week, but it will come out at some point once I've edited it all together. So do listen out for that one. Remember, share the podcast with a friend if you're listening on all major podcast providers. Our community is growing every single week. Our listeners are going up. We love hearing from fans that come to games and recognize us from the podcast. Tell us your Flyers stories. Reach out to us. hello@bristolflyers.co.uk. We'll read out every email on the show going forward. So thank you to all our podcast listeners and our podcast watchers on YouTube. Sam, anything else to add before we wrap up this week's episode of the podcast?
Mate, I've got a meeting in a sec. Can you let me out of here?
Right, I'm going to let Sam out of here. So I've got to cut him free from his shackles, but from Joel, Sam and producer Dan, thanks to our podcast partners at Web Gains, and we'll see you next time at the All-Star Game on the Bristol Flyers podcast.